Welcome back. I'm Sinead and this is Ooyang Beauty, and welcome to the last day of Ooyangness. I can't believe we finally made it. Now, there will be some more videos going up throughout the month, but as far as my first initial goal of uploading all the way through Christmas, we have met that goal. We are here. I am so excited because I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to do it, but I did it. In this video, as I'm sure you could tell from the title and the thumbnail, we're going to be playing around with the Kiko Milano Wonder Woman Collaboration Collection. This is not a brand new collection. It actually came out about 2 or 3 months ago, but when the collection first launched, I wasn't able to get it then. I had so many other products I was reviewing, so many other products coming in, so this one just had to be put on the back burner. But I was able to grab the collection in the Kiko Milano Black Friday sale. Everything was 50% off. This is actually a full collection. There's a primer, there's a foundation, eyeliner, mascara, lip product. There's a whole lot of products in this collection. I absolutely love Wonder Woman. She is one of my favorite superheroes. I love DC. I also love Marvel. I do not discriminate. I have my Wonder Woman shirt on today, and I also have my Wonder Woman tiara for my costume. I do the new 52 version, which is the version with the silver details and the blue boots instead of the gold details and the red boots. I just liked how this silver looked against my skin tone versus the gold, which is the main reason why I chose that version. Most of you already know, but for those of you that are new, my family is a family of cosplayers and costumers, and before the pandemic, we went to several conventions a year, some local, some that we travel to. I am also part of a volunteer children's group, and we do children's hospitals, we do children's events, things like that. I'm really, really hoping in 2021 we get to do a lot more and things slowly start getting back to normal. This has just been a rough year for everybody, and I'm really, really hoping for a better year in 2021. I think we all really, really need that. The reason why I chose this particular video to be my final video for Ooyangness is that this is also the day that the new Wonder Woman 1984 film is going to be premiering. It is premiering simultaneously in theaters and on HBO Max. But let's go ahead and get started. We have a lot of products that I want to show you here, and I cannot wait to show you how I put together this 1984 inspired look that is right here on my face right now. Let's go ahead and get started. I do not have a new primer, so I use my AOA Studio Face Blur Perfection Face Primer. This one I use in a full face of trying new to me makeup. That video should have gone up already. In fact, that video should have gone up right before this one, so yesterday. I absolutely love this primer. This is a foundation that we're going to be using. It is the Wonder Woman Born to Last Foundation 24-Hour Wear. I don't know anybody that wears their foundation for 24 hours, but supposedly this is supposed to have a 24-hour wear. It is a medium too high coverage finish. This is what the bottle looks like, you guys. I'm just all for this packaging. That is just so super, super cute. The shade I got is in caramel. It might be a little bit too light for me, but if it is, I do have my Milani bronzer that I can use to kind of warm it up. But shade might be pretty good. I'm using a little beauty blender here, a little sponge, and we're just going to start applying it. All right, right off the bat, that is actually a good shade. It's a good shade match. It's not too light. I'm curious to see if it's going to oxidize or not. So far, the finish is nice. It does have a little bit of a scent to it. I can't place it. It's like a body spray, a sweet kind of body spray, almost like maybe a candy scent. Just like I said, I can't place it. If you're somebody that's not big into fragrances, the Kiko Milano collection might be a little bit much for you because a lot of the products do have fragrance in them, and normally I don't like that, but this one isn't bothering me so much. Definitely seeing a medium to high coverage finish here. See if it's buildable. Seems to be building pretty good. The finish is looking really nice. This is a really pretty skin-like finish. I'm definitely enjoying that. I still have some product to the back of my hand, so a couple of pumps will go a long way with this one. Now we're going to do concealer. This is the skin tone concealer. This shade is in number 5. There's an actual shade color to it. It just says number 5. They didn't have a concealer in the Wonder Woman collection, so I just grabbed this one from their regular collection. That's what the concealer looks like. It has a decent doe foot on it. Let's see what the coverage is like. I'm going to put it right in here where I have the darkness, a little bit on the outside corner. Okay, that looks like it's going to be a decent match. It does not look like it's too light. Take my sponge, pat everything in. All right, with that first layer, it's definitely looking like it's more of a medium coverage. So I'm going to put a little bit more right in here It's definitely a light to medium coverage. It feels really nice. It's really creamy, but I'm not seeing a whole lot of coverage. I put a little bit around my nose, a little bit on my chin, a little bit on my forehead. It is definitely brightening. I will say I am definitely getting a really nice brightening under the eyes. The powder I'm going to be using is from the Unexpected Paradise Collection. It is a loose powder. It is in transparent, beautiful packaging. There wasn't a powder in the Wonder Woman collection either. Pull the little sticker off. Ooh, you see all that powder? Whoa. It has that same beachy fragrance as the Unexpected Paradise highlighter that we're going to be using today too. Smells really nice. Like I said, if you're someone that's not into fragranced makeup, you may not like it. Take my sponge and I'm going to press it into the powder. You guys know I like to use my sponge to press my powder in. I feel like it just gives me a smoother finish. That is very, very fine. That is an extremely light, fine powder. It's going right into the skin. Oh, that feels so nice. It's very silky. Now, it says it's transparent, but as you can see, there's a slight white cast to it. I'm sure that will blend and smooth out when I use my blush and all my other powder products I'm going to be applying. I'm going to fill my brows in real quick with this Bodyography pencil. It's in black walnut. This came out of a BoxyCharm box. So I'm just going to go ahead and fill everything in real quick. Now for the eyeshadow, we have the Wonder Woman From Another Planet eyeshadow palette. This is what the box looks like. Oh my god, I will definitely be keeping all the packaging. I'm just saying. This is what the packaging for the eyeshadow palette looks like. It's kind of hard to see with my ring light, but as you can see, it's kind of this blue stone-like finish to it. Absolutely love that. This is what the color story looks like. This is number two. This is the Warrior Princess Quad. I think there are two other color stories as well, but this is the one that I picked up. There was no fragrance in this eyeshadow palette, which I'm very, very happy about. I have some new brushes that I'm going to be trying out today. These are a gift from my best friend. She got these off of Amazon. I'm mixing my superhero genres here. These are from the Avengers. See, they're so cute. You have Thor, you've got Iron Man's glove here, this one is Spider-Man. These are just absolutely adorable. Highlight. There's a highlighting fan brush, an angled flat brush, a fluffy blush brush, a crease brush, and a flat shader brush. These are super soft. I'm going to go ahead and do a quick swatch of these shades. They look like they're mostly matte with a little bit of shimmer into them. Oh my god, that blue. So pretty. Oh my word. That's what they look like? Swatch. This one looks like it's more of a taupey shimmer shade. All of them seem to have a little bit of a shimmer to them. This is the bag that those brushes came in. Just super cute. I'm going to take this AOA brush first and I'm going to dip into the kind of a taupey shade here. I'm going to lay that down all over my lid. This is my first time using a Kiko Milano eyeshadow formula. I have used their blush and their highlighter formulas before, which I absolutely love. All right, this is very creamy, but as you can see, it has just a little bit of shimmer to it. I am loving the tones of this palette because it kind of goes with that whole 1984 vibe of the second film, which takes place in the 80s. And as we all know, in the 80s, there was a lot of shine. There was a lot of blue eyeshadow. Blue eyeshadow was the thing, which is one of the reasons why I picked up this particular color story. I just really, really liked that aspect of it. And I am already feeling very, very 80s with this look. Like, very, very 80s. Now I'm going to dip into that blue shade and I'm going to use my crease brush from the Avengers collection brushes here. This one is that Spider-Man one. Oh my god, I love the Avengers. I love DC. I love Marvel. I love it all. I do not discriminate. I love everything. But I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it right into my crease. Am I getting any fallout? So far, I do not see any fallout. I'm just going to slowly start blending it. This is such a nice, soft brush. Robin, thank you so much. I absolutely love these. She knows me so well. She's also a cosplayer. We've done several cons and children's events and stuff together. This year has just been really, really crappy. I did one event, I did two earlier. We had the Anime Blues remix in January, and then my daughter and I went to the Tupelo Comic Con in March, and that was like the last convention that we did. And then I did like a virtual children's event with my volunteer group here where I did Mulan, but other than that, we just haven't had any, you know, cosplaying, costuming experiences because we just haven't been able to do anything. I'm just really hoping that that changes next year and we can slowly start getting back into doing cons and events. But that shadow is really pretty. It's building up really nicely. It's a very, very creamy matte formula. One thing I'm noticing about the shadow right off the bat, it's not like super, super intensely pigmented. Like right when you first apply it to your eye, you do have to kind of build it up a little bit, and I do not mind that at all. And the fact that it's Wonder Woman, it could have been a crappy formula and I still would have loved it. It's Wonder Woman. I'm going to take my Japonesque detail brush here and I'm going to dip into the black, brownish, gray, smoky shade here. And I'm going to focus that on the outer corner. So I'm going to make things a little more smoky. That is beautiful. Wow. That is a gorgeous shade. It's black with just a little bit of brown to it. It has just a little bit of luminescent. It is so creamy. Wow, that is beautiful. Now we're going to take the shimmery gray shade with this flat shader brush. This one is the Iron Man inspired brush, and we're just going to kind of lay that all over the lid. That's pretty. It's not too shiny. It's got just a little bit of shimmer to it, not much. There's definitely some sparkle to it. I don't know if you can see that on camera. It definitely has just a little bit of sparkle going on in there. Very, very pretty. Now, Kika Milano is a Japanese-inspired brand, so it would not surprise me if the formulas are not super, super pigmented, because most of the time, Asian makeup, Asian-inspired makeup, Japanese, Korean, it's usually not super, super pigmented, but this has just the right amount of pigment. I am loving this. I'm going to take just a little bit of that light shimmer shade that we put all over our lid, and I'm going to focus that in the inner corner just to kind of brighten things up in that area. I have a little bit of the blue shadow on this angled brush. This one is the Thor-inspired brush, and I just want to lay that down close to my lash base here, just super close to the lash line. The Wonder Woman collection also came with an eyeliner and a mascara. We have the Wonder Woman Wonder Look Lasting Eye Marker and the Wonder Woman Wonder Last Volume Mascara 16 Hour Wear. Let's go into the eyeliner first. Depending on how the mascara looks, I may or may not throw on some lashes, but we will have to see. This is what the packaging for the eyeliner looks like. It's kind of hard to see. It's really, really shiny. Doesn't have that clickiness in it, and it is kind of lightweight. That's what the tip looks like. It's definitely more like a felt tip marker than it is a brush. Let's see how well it goes onto the eyes. I definitely want to do a big wing today. I'm like, can you even see what I'm doing? Filling in the lash base. Okay, right off the bat, does not glide on. Very smooth. That's because it's a, you know, when you have like a more of a felt tip kind of, when you have more of a felt tip and not a brush, it will kind of pull a little bit. It is super black, but it's definitely not going on as smooth as my more brush tip applicator pens. All right, I'm going to mash this on this eye and then we'll come back and we'll give the mascara a try. Now to give this mascara a spin. That is what the packaging looks like. It matches the eyeshadow palette with that really pretty kind of stone finish look to it. And that is a brush. This is a pretty big brush, but it looks like it might separate pretty well. It's supposed to be a volumizing mascara, so we will see. I'm going to go ahead and give my lashes a quick curl before we do the mascara. I'm definitely looking forward to giving a new formula a try. All right, so far it is separating really nicely. I'm not seeing a whole lot of volumizing off the bat, but I do like the fact that it is separating and it is definitely defining my lashes. That's for sure. All right, that's the first coat. I do like it. It's definitely defining. It's definitely separating. Let's see what it does with a second coat. All right, there we go. I am definitely seeing that thickness now. I'm definitely seeing that volumizing. That is pretty. This is a very nice formula. This brush, it is separating so nicely. Now we have the Wonder Woman Starlight Blush. This shade is in number 3, Athena Strategy. There were 3 different shades. This shade was the one that I liked the most. And that is what the packaging looks like. It's similar to the eyeshadow palette, but this one is red. Oh my God, I just love that. That's what the shade looks like. It's kind of a pinky red shade. It smells like it has a slight sweet fragrance to it, but it's very, very light. It's not super fragranced like the other products are the foundation and the powder. Go ahead and put a little bit on my brush. I'm using the fluffy blush brush in my Avengers brushes here, and we're going to start laying that down. Oh, that's a lot of pigment. Oh, that's a lot of pigment. Okay, let's go a little bit more light. A little bit more light there. Although, you know, super red bright blush is very 80s, you know what I mean? Definitely goes with the aesthetic, but that is blending so beautifully. There's a light, slight shimmer to it. Do you see that? I may not even need to use a highlighter. This looks like it has enough shine all on its own. Pretty formula. Definitely, definitely glowy. Okay, I definitely feel very, very 80s right now with this look. They definitely went all out with that 1984 inspired look with these tones. Definitely, definitely very, very 80s. I'm going to do just a tiny bit of highlighter with the Unexpected Paradise highlighter here. This is in Golden River. I'm going to take just a touch with the fan brush here from the Avengers brush collection. I'm going to mostly focus that back here. So pretty. I absolutely love this highlighter. It has just a slight bit of glitter to it, but it's so fine that it's not like super, super glittery all over your face. A little bit on the Cupid's bow. Take a little bit down the center of the nose. I'm going to set everything down real quick using my Urban Decay All-Liner Setting Spray. I probably should have done this before I did my mascara, but you know, here we are. I'm going to let that dry down and then we'll come back and try out our lip product. And that will be the full look completed. Now let's try out our lip product. This is the Wonder Woman Metal Power Lasting Lip Paint. This is what the box looks like. On point, along with everything else. This is shade number 5. This is the tube. This is so nice. That's what it looks like up close. It's kind of hard to see the packaging because of my ring light and everything is just so metallic and iridescent, but that is so nice. First thing I'm going to do is line my lips. This is my ColourPop Lippy Pencil in Overtime. So that is what the doe foot looks like. It looks like it has a slight little curve in there to curve on the lips. This says it is a lip paint, so I'm wondering if it's something like a lip stain and not necessarily a matte liquid lipstick. All right, super opaque. Oh, that is pretty. There's a slight bit of like little shimmery iridescence to it. Oh, that's pretty. Definitely has a slight fragrance. It's not strong. It's very, very light. I'm loving how this brush is just curving right over my lips. That is a beautiful shade. It feels really, really nice and comfortable on the lips. I'm going to give it about a minute or so just to see if it dries down. Then we'll come back and we'll do a little kiss test real quick. All right, it's been about a minute. Let's do a quick kiss test. Oh, nice. There's a little bit of transfer, but not much. So this is definitely going to be a little bit more long wearing. I absolutely love it. All right, let's go ahead. I'm going to pull you guys out a little bit, and then we're going to do our final thoughts. All right, and we're back. Let's go ahead and do some final thoughts. I went ahead and threw on my Wonder Woman tiara from my Wonder Woman costume. I thought it would be fun to kind of complete the overall look. First of all, the packaging. Every single thing in this collection was on point. Kiko Milano did such a wonderful job with all the details. I absolutely love it. I would definitely be keeping the packaging. And now for the collection itself. The Born to Last foundation, I absolutely love this. I was afraid that the foundation and the concealer were going to be the wrong shades, but as you can see, they actually worked out very nicely. My skin has a semi-matte to matte finish to it, but it's very, very light. It looks really skin-like. I am loving how this foundation is looking. The concealer is looking really nice too. It's not giving me as much coverage as I like, but it's really, really brightening and it looks really, really nice. It's very skin-like. I do like the finish. The powder is also nice. This is from the Unexpected Paradise collection. There wasn't one for the Wonder Woman collection. The only negative to it is that it has a very strong, beachy, coconut kind of suntan lotion scent. If you're very sensitive to fragrances, it might be too much for you, especially combined with the fragrance in the foundation, but the finish itself, so nice. It is so super, super fine. Blend it right into the skin. It just feels so nice. I absolutely love it. The eyeshadow quad and the blush, both of these are really, really nice. I love how smooth and creamy the formula is in the eyeshadow palette. It wasn't super pigmented right off the bat, but that's fine. They build it up so beautifully. And I absolutely loved this blush. When I first put it on, I was like, whoa, had to kind of tone it down a little bit. I had a little bit too much going on. But, you know, it's 1984 inspired. In the 1984, we wore a lot of blue and a lot of pink blush. So, you know, it goes right with the theme. And as you can see, it has a little bit of a glow to it, a little luminescence. Normally, I like a matte blush. This is just such an overall beautiful finish. Then we have the eyeliner and the mascara. The eyeliner was a felt tip and not a brush, so it did tug and pull just a little bit. It was a little bit hard to work with, but it is super black and it is super matte. I do like that. The mascara was really nice too. This is what it looks like after three coats. I think it built up really, really nicely. The brush did a really good job of separating. The formula is very defining. It is buildable. It's not my most favorite mascara formula, but it is really nice. I do like it. And last, we have the lip paint. This is actually one of my favorite products in this entire collection. It went on so opaque, so smooth. It did dry down, but it's so comfortable. It does not feel dry. It doesn't feel like it's going to crack or anything throughout the day. It just feels very, very soft and comfortable on the lips. All right, guys, and that was the end of Uyamis. I hope you enjoyed this series. This is my first time attempting to do this many videos in 1 month, but I think it actually went pretty well. I'm pretty excited about the fact that I was actually able to accomplish it. If you get a chance to try any of these products, let me know. Drop them down in the comment box below. Let me know what you thought about them. If you do get the chance to see the film, let me know what you think about that too. If you're new to my channel, I would love it if you subscribe and join my little family. And if you'd like to be notified of any videos that may be coming up in the future, just be sure to tap the notification bell down below. Right down there, you'll be notified each and every time. Be safe, take care of yourself, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.